Forgot to give him the start cue. So it's my privilege to welcome you once again to Norwich United Church and this special service of Remembrance. It is soon Remembrance Day again, and this year obviously is going to be a little different. And we as a people will, as a nation, will acknowledge the sacrifice of people in the armed forces throughout history. However, as a community of faith today, we'll be taking some time to reflect on the sacrifices of members of this sanctuary and our extended family members. Members of the United Church of Canada have served in every major conflict since our church's formation in 1925, and still do today. So it's appropriate for us to affirm the lives lost and mourned, and bring them to mind here with us as we worship in freedom and peace. I invite you to join me in the call to worship. On this Remembrance Sunday, we gather to pray. On this day when the guns once fell silent, on this day of hope, in this time of story, song, and prayer, help us live together to catch a vision of how the world could live together. And in that spirit, let our hearts join in song. Voices United 381, Spirit of Life. Pray for peace. May it start with peace in our hearts. Amen. Almighty and eternal God, from whose love in Christ we cannot be parted, either by death or life,
as well as at home, has inspired many to follow in their footsteps. Betty and Godfrey's mission, story, and passion live on those they have influenced. Thanks to mission and service, they are part of a great cloud of witnesses that the United Church of Canada of today is built on. We will remember them. If mission and service giving is already a regular part of your life, thank you so much. If you have not given, please join me in making mission and service giving a regular part of your life of faith, loving our neighbors at the heart of our mission and service. Thank you for your time.
And now Elizabeth is going to offer a reading of In Flanders Fields.
In Flanders Fields, the poppy glow between the crosses grow on row, that marker placed in the sky, the lark still bravely singing fly, scarce heard amid the guns below. We are the dead, short days ago, we live, till dawn until sunset glow. Loved and were loved, and now we lie in Flanders Fields. Take up our quarrel with the foe, to you from failing hands we throw. The torch be yours to hold it high, if ye break faith with us who die. We shall not sleep, though poppies grow in Flanders Fields.
And Elizabeth asked me to let you know that book that she was reading from is available in the library downstairs. You got to wipe everything down after you visit. No one person's allowed in at a time, but the library is open. Please join me in our words of remembrance. They shall not grow old as we that are left grow old. At the going down of the sun, and in the morning. We will now conduct a reading, viewing of our roles of honor. This was kind of I put it together in a week. A lot of you reached out and helped, and there was a lot of contributions from a lot of places, and this is what we managed to put together. It's by no means complete, but if anybody wants to help work on it, we can do that for next year. And now our roles of honor. eternal rest grant unto them, O God, and may perpetual light shine upon them. May the souls of righteousness, through your great mercy, rest in peace. Amen. Our next hymn is Voices United, 506, Take My Love.
Tim's going to work some technical magic and in sports and games during my time at school. But you never know, because I have nothing to show for my participation. I was not particularly good at any sport. And that's just a nice way of saying that I sucked at most. I never won any trophies or awards. And in those days, you did not get a ribbon or medal for participation. But I participated anyway. I am reminded of an interesting conversation a dad shared that he had with his son as he took him to lacrosse practice. His son asked him, "Daddy, do we get trophies for playing lacrosse this spring?" He answered, "No, but you do get to go out and run around and have lots of fun while learning to play." "Okay," his son said. Then he turned and ran out onto the field for the start of the practice. Now I think that father got it right. Participation matters, but not just for the trophy. Participation matters, not only in sports, but in all of life. Participation matters in the kingdom of God, and not just for the rewards. We can draw that lesson from the parable told in today's gospel reading. The parable speaks of 10 bridesmaids who were invited to participate in a wedding ceremony. They were awaiting the arrival of the bridegroom, and he was late, extremely late. They waited until all their energy and enthusiasm had waned, and they fell asleep. Now that is understandable. It happens to us too. Waiting drains our energy and dilutes our enthusiasm. There have been many times when we set out on a pursuit or offered ourselves in service with great energy and enthusiasm. We were excited. We were bursting with ideas. We had great expectations. Good things were going to happen, and quickly. We showed up. We did what we had to do. And we waited. And waited. And waited. But we did not see what we expected to see. The change did not happen, at least not as quickly as we thought. Gradually, our energy evaporated and our enthusiasm waned. We didn't quite give up, but we gave in. We gave in to discouragement and despair. We surrendered to a state of drowsiness and apathy. We may be physically present, but that's about all. That can and often happen when waiting is prolonged. Whether it is waiting for a breakthrough in our health, our finances, our relationships, a cause that we champion, an increase in the vibrancy and growth of our congregation, whatever it is that we are hoping for, prolonged waiting can get to us. That was the state of all 10 bridesmaids in the parable. The waiting got to them at the fantasy, the oral fantasy. But in the parable, five of them were described as wise and five as foolish. Now, what was different between those two sets of bridesmaids? From the parable, we see that it had to do with how they approached the invitation to participate in the ceremony. Those who were wise went prepared with extra oil, so that when, after a prolonged wait, the bridegroom finally arrived, they were ready to participate. While those described as foolish did not go prepared to wait, and so they were not ready to participate when the time came. Now let us get a little bit of a background to this parable. During the time when this parable was told, the practice at weddings was for the groom to go with his friends to the bride's house in the evening of the wedding day. They would collect the bride and her friends, and they would then process back to the groom's house with singing and dancing. The invited guests would form a torchlight procession back to the groom's house where the banquet would take place. That is why in the parable, the bridesmaids were waiting with their lamps. The invitation that the bridesmaids received was primarily an invitation to participate in the procession and all that went along with it. Because it was during the procession that the bride and the groom were put on display, as it were. It was during the procession that they were introduced to the community and welcomed. It was during the procession that they were affirmed and celebrated by all. That was the most important and significant part of the ceremony. The banquet was but the culmination of all of that. Now the wise bridesmaids, they went prepared to participate in the procession and all that it involved and signified. The foolish bridesmaids apparently went with their eyes on the banquet. They took just enough oil to get them there. That would explain why, when they turned up after the procession was over, presumably with oil and their lamps lit, they were refused entry to the banquet. The foolish bridesmaids were excluded because they didn't quite grasp the significance of the occasion. The invitation was about the procession and less so about the banquet. And when they missed the procession, they missed the part that mattered most. My friends, where do we fall? Among the wise or the foolish? As we go about our various pursuits, are we missing out on those things in life that matter most? God invites us, all of us, to a life of significance, not just success. And when we participate in life, not just for the reward that we may receive, but in order to add value and give meaning to our own lives as well as the lives of others, we are engaging ourselves in that which matters most. When we seek for significance, not just success, it is easier for us to keep going when things are not turning out as we expect. Because we know that we are involved in something that is way greater than ourselves. So we can continue to love, even when that love is not being returned. We can continue to seek for reconciliation, even when obstacles continue to emerge. We can continue to work for justice, even when the structures that promote injustice appear to be unyielding. We can continue to hope, even when all seems lost. We can continue to offer ourselves in service, even when change and renewal is slow in coming. And when our energy wanes, as it would from time to time, we can pick ourselves up and continue on, because we know that we are involved in something of significance, of great significance. My friends, when we pursue that kind of life, we become more attuned to those joy-filling moments when God's Spirit breaks through our questioning, our doubts, and our tiredness, and gives us reasons to sing and dance and celebrate like those wise bridesmaids. And those times, my friends, often come when we least expect. This life that we live is not meant to be just a pathway to something else. It is meant to be valued, enjoyed, celebrated, and shared for all that it is. And there is much joy and fulfillment when we do so. Daddy, the little boy asked, do we get trophies for playing lacrosse this spring? The father answered, no, but you get to go out and run around and have lots of fun while learning. My friends, God invites us to go out and participate as fully as possible in life with God and with one another. God invites us to live lives of significance, not just success, and to have lots of fun while we learn to live as God would have us. I pray, God, that we participate in this life to which we are called, and that we will do so not just for the trophies.
Our next hymn is from Voices United, 686, God of Grace and God of Glory.
Thank you.
certainly through gifts of dollars and cents, but also through courageous action, faithful service, and loving devotion. Let us share of ourselves and of what God has so graciously given. And if you did not get your opportunity to place your offering in the plates at the back when you came in, you also have the opportunity to place them there when you leave. Would you join me in a prayer of dedication of these gifts? Gracious God, bless these gifts and these givers. May they be used well to foster peace and joy in this world and in the lives of those who cross our paths. Now, a couple weeks ago, I offered you thank you as your hands ASL sign of the week. We're going to get a little fancy now. We're going to go Thanksgiving. We're going to give thanks and we're going to give it away. So you take your chin, put it in your hand, and you give it away. Thanksgiving. Did you guys get that? Yeah. Kind of like this then. You take it, you put it in your hand, and then you give it away. Yeah. And so now I'd like to invite you to join me in the prayer of thanksgiving and intercession. Knowing a prayer for people of courage on Remembrance Sunday. We offer to you, O God, our prayers for those who seek justice and resist evil. We pray for those who need your presence and strength to stand firm. For those who oppose the use of violence in any form, in faithful response to the Prince of Peace. We pray for those who are prepared to be firm to protect those in danger. We pray for those who walk with others who need strength. We pray for those who protest, for those who organize letter campaigns, for those who give sacrificially on behalf of others. We pray for those who speak the unpopular truth, who protect the unpopular victims, who choose the unpopular path of peace. We pray for those who do not let their desire for peace hinder the requirements of justice, and for those who do not let their zeal for justice override the call for peace. In Jesus' name, in remembrance of the sacrifice he gave, amen. Now, having gathered and remembered, heard, given, and prayed, we ask Almighty God for your blessing and for your continued presence in our lives. Remind us that no matter where we go, you are there. No matter how bleak the world becomes, all it takes is one ray of light for a new day to be upon us once again. Amen. Go in peace. Our closing hymn is Walk With Me.
Christine has gone outside and has set up a big table of